That's what here they do. They say bone density. These are known as biomarkers. They call it as biomarkers. Based on the biomarkers, say, oh, your sight is should be 20/20. You have maybe this. That means you are aging. You are aging. So you this is your bone density means you are aging. That is what those are as biomarkers. So there is a technique to reverse the biological age. Now suppose I am 50, let's say. What I feel is I am 25 years old. I am 25 years old and so for that, if you want to write down, you can write it, or you can want to remember, you can remember it. Just say these words every day, looking at the mirror or for yourself, everybody. Suppose my age is 50, that's what we stood at, right? Now we go and say that, mirror, go to the mirror or to yourself, say these words exactly. Day by day, in every way, day by day, in every way, I am expanding my physical and mental capacities. I am repeating. Day by day, in every way, I am expanding my physical and mental capacities. My biostat is 25 years.
My biostat is 25 years.
I look and feel.
I look and feel.
A healthy 25 years.
A healthy 25 years.
Suppose if you want to go further, you can. Okay? I repeat.
Day by day.
Day by day, in every way, I am expanding my physical and mental capacities. My biostat is 25 years.
25 years.
What about for kids who are like 10 years?
They don't need. What they should is, I am very strong. They should feel it.
That's it.
So, because you don't say minus 25. So, okay, 25, and I look and feel a healthy 25 years.
I look and feel a healthy
25 years. And the research has been done in Harvard University. What they found is, when the people started doing this, their bone density looked like a 25 years old. They reversed it, everything, like a 25 years old. This has been proven technology. I am not just telling because I just came up with something technology. No, this is the proven technology. When you do this every day and go to the doctor at the age of 50 years, he will say that, how come you have a 25 years old body? And even bone density can be reversed. That's what I'm saying. Don't say that, okay, I can't reverse it. You can, you can, you can. That's it. There is no word called can't. Don't use the word can from your dictionary. Okay, follow this. So now tell me, what is that I told her? Can you repeat?
Day by day, in every way.
I look and feel a healthy 25 years. You want to repeat again?
We want to write it down.
Yes.
Yeah, we have to write it.
Because whenever you look into the mirror, whenever you sit and want to, like you are waiting in the tram or waiting in the bus stop, wherever, you know, in the car for somebody, don't waste your time. Day by day, in every way. Just do this, no? This will really help you. Your eyesight will improve. Your sleep patterns will improve. Your blood flow will improve. Your bone density will improve. Your hearing capacity will improve. Okay, I'll give you the good news. What they did was, they went to Uzbekistan. You know that place, Uzbekistan. What they did was, they experimented their average age in Uzbekistan is 90 to 100 years, average lifespan. Then they asked me, how come you are living 90 to 100 years healthily and their hair will always be black, no coloring? It's a pure white, sorry, pure black. And there's a thick and dense hair. Oh my God, what happened? Why you guys have a very healthy body even at the age of 90 and 100 years? And they used to go for hiking, mountain hiking. Then what they reveal, you know, the first symptom they suggest is happiness. They feel happy. When you feel happy, they said your lifespan is increased by default by 12 years. When you just feel happy. Then they said, not only happy, we were close to nature. We were close to nature. And the other thing is, the respect we derive from other people coming to us and talking to us and taking advices, that really strengthened our belief system in ourselves and really pumped our lifespan. So this is the research done. So this is very powerful research, and this is called biostat. When you feel anger, you know, healthy, strong, that means no disease will come to you. And you are reversing your aging. That means you are growing younger, living longer. So there is a beautiful book, if you want you can read. This is called Grow Younger, Live Longer by Deepak Chopra. He has defined everything very beautifully. And the third thing is called psychological age. What is psychological age? I am 15 years old. I feel like, oh my God, what is this one? So every time laziness, you know, I don't want to do things. You feel bad about it, depressed. You know, every time depressed. That means my psychological age is 15 years. I am physically 15 years, chronologically 15 years, my psychologically I am 15 years. When you are depressed, diseased, like you feel bad about it, what is life, what is the purpose? You feel negatively, bombarding your body with the negative words, you know, negative thinking. That means your psychological age is zzzz. When they measure the bone density, their bone density will be 50 years old density. So your negative words, negative thoughts, negative actions will influence your health. So you can reverse. That is the reason I said you are 100% responsible for your own life. Nobody is responsible for your diseases, your life. Don't blame. Stop the blame game. We are responsible for everything we are experiencing in this life or any life. Karma bhogam. You are experiencing the results of actions. One person went to one Mahatma, one master, and said, my two kidneys gone. What karma I did this birth? I didn't hurt anybody. I have been very helpful. What happened? Why my kidneys? My kidneys are gone. Two kidneys. In previous birth, you started killing people and now you repent for that you lost two kidneys. He was stabbing everybody. Can you believe that? He was doing all cruel acts in his past birth. Now, when it comes to the suffering, now he says, what did I do? Because he don't remember. So not only actions, your words, your thoughts will affect. Remember this. Then don't say that, don't blame. Why should I suffer? Why am I suffering this disease, that disease? Because is a result of your own actions. And you have the power to reverse them. You have the 100% power. Remember this, please remember. Everything you can reverse it. Even your bad, the karma, you can reverse it. That is the power of. Okay, so to have some fun, I'll teach you one technique. This is good. That will give some energy. What you do is, I'll just demonstrate first. Okay? Don't laugh. Okay, 1, 2, 3. This is very good for to increase into brain power, the mental capacities. Okay? Breathe in, okay? Sa 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 breathe in, and when you breathe out, you say. That means here, say, just imagine, like just say sa 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 sa. Where does the vibration come? Just put your hand here and feel it. Say sa 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 sa. Do you see the vibrations here?
Yes.
This is very powerful too for the people who attend for competitive examinations. The brain power is so, it will increase to many folds. Whichever the exam you attempt, it must be A plus. That's it. Such is the power of this technique. And your, you know why I'm telling this? I remove keys as soon as I come out, come into the house, and keep somewhere, and I forget. That is how we do, right? And what we do is, we put cell phone somewhere and say, hey, can you call cell phone from house number? We don't recognize where it is because we are so mindless. And we don't know where we are keeping things. We are totally disorganized. And what will happen? Your mental capacity you are losing. You want a shortcut for to that, right? But you don't want to what? Change. So what we should do is we have to improve our mental capacity so that we remember things correctly. In the parking lot in the mall, we park and we search for ding 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 ding, you know? And we don't know where it is. We lose the track of car. So, see, these are all daily happenings. And we eat food and we watch TV, we talk, okay? Multi-processing, parallel processing. We eat, talk, watch. How can food get digested? Tell me. Because you don't even chew. Right? And you don't know how much food you eat. Next thing is on the dining table, we'll have a lot of books, pencils. You know? All the crap and you eat on the dining table. See, these are all the normal things. First thing is when we eat, cell phones should be off. Television should be off. No thinking. Thinking should be stopped. Just focus on it. Then, we don't eat much. You know, while talking or watching movie, then that's it. We don't know how much we eat. How much quantity we eat. I saw one person eating 40 idlis. Then I said, what happened? Everybody started laughing. Then I said, what happened? How many idlis you get? 4, 5?
Add 0.
So he ate 40 idlis. Such is the power of watching TV. But the problem is, if you can't digest it, that is a problem. Finished. Yeah. That will, fat is accumulated. So these are the basic techniques. So this will improve brain power and it will activate all the brain cells. There won't be any dead cells in the brain. Remember this. Because out of brain capacity, we are using only 3 to 4%. 96% was a dark matter in the brain. So that is the reason we cannot execute a task 100% accuracy. What we can do is, we can activate the cells in the brain to such an extent, we can give the 100% result. I mean, we can work with 100% focus and capacity. For this, this technique will be very useful. Right. That's it.
What is this called again? What is this exercise?
Sahasrara exercise. Like what do this? It will. It's a brain activity exercise basically. You breathe in and say sa. And this is also useful for the mentally handicapped children. When you do this, what will happen is, it will, as the brain cells are activated, then their activity will be increased. This is the main thing, right? When it is activated, then it will really help them. The stuttering will go. Stuttering, stammering, this will also go.
How many times will you have?
This one? At least 3 times. Minimum 3 times. Minimum 3 times. As per your capacity, 5, 7 times. It is as per your capacity.
Memory.
Yes. Yeah. And in the afternoon, I am going to give the mudras. This is called Shankh Mudra. This is called, you hold this thumb with right hand and touch the fingers with this, like, you know, thumb. This is called Shankh Mudra. You know why? Most of the complaints is, children don't eat food. The appetite will increase by just doing Shankh Mudra for the kids. And the stammering and stuttering will go away from the kids. This is called Shankh Mudra. You hold this with your face. The thumb should touch all the fingers. If you hold it every day.
Is it right to left or left to right?
No, left thumb, you hold it with right hand. Left thumb, you hold it with right hand. And just turn and touch the thumb of right hand with the left hand fingers. So this will remove stuttering, stammering for the kids, improve appetite for the kids, and improve concentration for the kids. This is Shankh Mudra.
You just stay there for a couple of minutes?
10 minutes.
Like this?
Like this. Yeah. Just close your eyes and sit. This will improve. I strongly suggest for kids this one. Shankh Mudra, this is called, which I am going to cover in the next session, but I'm just, because Sahasrara, it will go with Sahasrara, you can say sa, you can do that too. This will help.
What is it called? Sahasrara?
Sahasrara Kriya, that is Prana Kriya, none of the, okay? And I'm going to give now the Kapalabhati variants, but there is one more technique called Bhastrika. Mm-hmm. Bhastrika, you know, faster pace of breathing. Okay, you breathe fast. This is the Bhastrika. So, to do this, you know, there's a few techniques which will help Bhastrika to be very effective. What you do is, when you drag, see, you pull the air when you breathe in, just pull out, or when breathe out, you say. gathering air and pulling throwing out. Okay, what you do is you gather the air when you breathe in and breathe out, throw. Okay, then slowly improve. Right. Okay. So this is one. Bhastrika, this is very important. And the other thing is like gathering air from here. Okay. This is third variation. You are taking energy from Mother Earth and giving it to her. See. Okay. You see the energized?
Yeah.
You feel it?
Yes.
That is called Bhastrika. This is a very powerful technique. In movements, we get energized.
It's getting close to 1 o'clock.
Oh, it's close.
So it's another. If you want to do get anything done prior to lunch, better to have be done before lunch. You can have that one done. Then after 15-20 minutes, we break out for lunch.
Okay. Sorry, I lost track of time.
We did too. Thank
okay.
you.
Okay. So this is the Bhastrika. Okay. This is very important. And Kapalabhati, there is another variance. What you do is, you can do this and do the Kapalabhati. This will help different parts of abdomen. Like, see, when you say this is one effect, when you do this, it will have a lower abdomen.
I heard different versions of this that. It should be 1 second per breath, or should do it fast. Which is the correct ultimate goal?
Slow on pace, which will have effect, you know. Because it's a 1 second per breath, that is the correct one, basically. But in that fast pace, what happens is we might, our blood pressure might increase and there are something problems. That's the reason we say.
But if you can do it faster, it's okay. It's better or.
Like if you have all these symptoms, high blood pressure or any blood pressures, any symptoms, then it is not at
all. No, it's just nothing. Everything is okay.
Then everything is okay, then 1 second per one breath is good. 60 breaths per minute, Kapalabhati. This is the most powerful technique. I advise everybody to do it. 15 minutes. And your cholesterol will become zero. I mean,
bad cholesterol.
I mean,
obesity.
Yeah, obesity. Because
diabetes.
Yes, it improves. It helps in diabetes. It helps in many diseases. All toxins will go away. And another variation of this, third variation of Kapalabhati, you keep hands behind and say, keep the head tilted, okay?
Are we not violating that? Keeping the spine and legs straight when we do the
post. Yeah, but this technique exception. There is an exception given for this technique because they wanted to focus on the upper abdomen. The three layers, lower abdomen, abdomen and upper abdomen, like this area, diaphragm area, to give more space for this body parts.
We should arch the back?
No, arch the neck, not the back. Body will be straight, but the neck will be tilted. Okay? And the other thing is, if you want, if you can, you can also do this. Just and also on the left side. These are the variances of Kapalbhati. Because the main purpose is all parts here gets cleansed, massaged. So, and this will really help. And most of the for diabetes, like mostly, what we can do is this is the manduk, mandukasan. Manduk means frog. You know that, right? What you do is normally you put the hands and do this. Okay. What you do is, for doing this, just breathe in and breathe out. Just and keep hands here so that there will be pressure on your pancreas and liver. Okay. Breathe out. And look up.
Look up this way.
Look up, yeah, like this. There should be pressure. So it, when there is a pressure on your
here,
yes,
or here,
here. When you bend, so that fist will press the pancreas. You see now? You can. There should be a pressure on your pancreas, liver, these areas. What is the cause of diabetes? The pancreas. So you should have some pressure. Okay. And there is other technique also. Those who can, like you have a stable, like a sugar levels, what they can do is Pavan Muktasana. This is called Pavan Muktasana. This is very useful. It's a lying posture and it's very useful. Everybody can do this. Okay. What you do is give one foot while breathing in. Okay. While breathing out, you try to hug your foot. So there will be pressure here. And same way, breathe in. While breathing out, stomach will go in and then say, hold it. Okay? Then third variance is breathing in. Then if you like it so much, you say, so, this is very helpful for your spinal cord. Okay? So this is called Pavan Muktasana. If you can do like this, or even if you cannot even lie down, what you can do is, you can put pressure here. Okay? So that it will give some amount of. Some little pressure on the system. Yeah, lie down and. No, you bring back up while breathing out and try to kiss the knee.
Is it this way?
Yes.
Or you bring this.
No, no. Just see, there are two variances I told you. One is lying, and this one is just only by sitting. Here there is no sleep. Lying down posture. Just by sitting, if you want to do it, just give the pressure. Okay? Okay. For the back pain, this is very, very common problem. I am going to teach you the Nabhi Yoga. This is a 3-step process. I want everybody to do it. Okay? So the first technique is, can you come? Lie down, I'll show you. Please see it very carefully. Lie down. No, on the back, on your stomach. Okay. Now, touch your left leg. Yeah. Bring this hand and hold the right leg. Yeah. Hold the right leg and bring this forward and just raise and raise your left leg too. Yeah. Just like a boat posture. See up, upwards. Yeah. That's it. Okay. You see it? Okay. Yeah. Enough. So there will be a pressure here on this part. So this is the first technique. Okay. So now sit.
First variation.
The first variation. Sit like this and then do it. Do this. Right leg. Yeah, left leg. Then see. Bring this hand. Okay, keep the hand here. Twist. Try to see left. You see this? That's fine. Yes. Yeah. Because normally people can't. Yeah, that's good. No, that's fine. Yeah. There should be twist here. You see that? There should be twist. Okay. So this is the second technique. And the third, you stand up and then say right hand up and bend. Like, bend, yes. Right hand up and bend. That's it. No, only right side.
Only right side.
Only one side. Okay, three techniques, I told you.
So all of these are only one side?
Only one side, only right hand, because for the right-handed people, always should be, right hand should always be upper side. See, the first thing she did was, she lifted right hand and the left leg, like that, right? And the second one, she brought the right hand here and twisted, right hand up. What is the third one? She lifted right hand and this.
So you don't have to
be
the other side.
Okay.
So if you're a left-handed person like me.
If you're a left-handed person, everything should be left.
Okay.
So how will it balance for the left side for the right-handed person?
Okay. So that's a good question. The reason for this Nabhi Yoga means always for the right-handed person, the Nabhi center, which gives the perfect balance to your body, is twist like left-oriented. What we are doing, by doing this exercise, you are bringing that balance, centeredness. That's called, that's the reason it's called as Nabhi Yoga. Okay? So, navel science, it's called navel science. That means you are centering your Nabhi. This is a very crucial part in your body. So that you are bringing in the balance. All these disc problems in the back comes because of this disorientation of your navel. So we are bringing it back so that it's stiff, perfect. This really helps. Okay, one more time. Those who have not seen. Okay. How do you do this? First. Okay. This right leg.
Straight. Straight the hand.
Okay.
Yeah.
You have to do this.
No, actually you have to hold the left leg.
Your left hand should touch the right leg.
So he is left handed.
Oh, he is left handed.
Your
okay.
left hand
so should right
touch the right leg, right. Yeah. And
so you lift the left
leg. Lift left leg and right hand.
lift
no,
this leg.
You're left
yes,
hand, right?
Yes.
So
yes.
Just keep running.
Yes.
This one should touch the other
this
leg.
One and lift
that
this
other
leg.
Leg.
Lift
and
other
that's
leg. That's
it.
That's
it. That's
the
yes. Yes. That's that way.
Breathe normally.
Yeah, breathe normally. Yeah, just like a boat. Yes. Are you also
the other way?
Yeah. Oh, you're also lifting.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You have to lift the left.
Only one, like three times.
The problem is something with
the
task bar. That means Roja
chair. No, no, no.
Adi,
the right leg is resting on the floor or it is on the
ankle? Adi,
Adi.
No, yeah, like you can pull it as well.
Like you want to
pull it. Oh, that's nice. But normally you can pull it this much. Once you get practice, like when you gain practice, you can pull it upwards.
And left leg
also. You have to set me that.
How long do you want to hold it for?
Oh, yeah.
In a few seconds. A few seconds. 1 minute is minimum.
One minute, 60 seconds, if you can, but start with 10 seconds.
Okay. And this not only improves your back pain,
but
it improves all the problems related to your lower abdomen. Okay, from here onwards, all the pains you have. And the second thing is, you sit like this. Because of my clothing, see, you see, then, get twisted, right hand, upper side, either if you can't reach further, you see, either you can keep it like this, see, this should not come like that, or go like that. So you should stand. And you're pushing. This should go further down. See, that chair there. No, am I doing right? Yeah, you are doing right. Should I do this side or this side? That side. Okay. And this is also for the right leg only? Right hand, yeah.
This is also for right-handed.
Only. Right-handed only. Yes.
Okay.
This is all for right-handed.
Right-handed.
Yeah, you can. See, yeah, that's various.
Yes, but not. Not mandated.
You can do both sides.
Not mandated. Yeah.
So,
it just want
so
to make sure
way?
That right hand is up. I just wanted to make sure.
So this. So if it is, if you want to do this.
Mm-hmm.
So do you still push your hand with the?
Yes.
And
give some pressure.
Yeah.
That is the correct. By this time you would have got a good back.
Yeah.
Right?
Just prepared to lift some.
Yeah. Now the third thing, you didn't go get up. And then stand up and say, lift the right hand, feet together, then bend. Only right hand.
So, actually the palm should face upright.
That's fine. Like you can bend like this or like this, whichever. But I suggest to bend like that.
What about the breathing at the time? You have to do
don't worry about
whatever
breathing,
breathing.
Yeah, normal breathing.
Okay.
What if you're ambidextrous?
Huh?
What if you're ambidextrous?
What?
What?
Oh, ambidextrous, okay. You do both.
So you got it right, remember.
Okay. So these three steps will remove most of the diseases related to from this part to lower part, and it will improve digestion. It will remove that acid reflux problems.
How about fat?
Hmm?
Fat.
Oh, fat is reduced.
Uttar Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh.
That's good.
Much,
yeah.
Always.
What time of the day you should do it?
Morning is the best time. See, for yoga, morning is the best time.
You can't do after food, I think. No, don't. And just out of curiosity, I'm asking. Say you're sitting in your office,
mm-hmm.
and can you start doing Kapalbhati just like that?
Oh yes, that is always suggested.
I know it's weird, but
yes, that is suggested. See, suppose you want to do this exercise, there's a person who was telling this. Throw some pen. So you want to do exercise, you can do this. Throw pen. So you can do all kinds of exercise, bending, backward. Okay. Because it is, I am concerned about time.
Sai, forgot to mention, after doing this Nabi Yoga, you shouldn't do any asana.
Yes, yeah, one more thing. After doing this Nabi Yoga, no other asana should be exercised. Attempted. This should be the last one. These steps. These steps that I suggested, this is called Nabi Yoga. After doing all exercises, this should be the last step. After this, don't attempt any other steps.
Shavasana.
No, for this one.
No, see, this one that we did, even in the beginning we did, and we did the stretching.
Oh, stretching is okay, but
so
when you do the as
in this Nabi Yoga and the regular stretching that we did.
This three is a package.
No, this three is a package.
Okay.
Like first, like if you want to do stretching, you do it before Nabi Yoga.
Okay. That is both sides we do. And
both sides,
do,
yeah. This should be the final one. This only for back. On the back, there's other thing called, can you lie down on your stomach? For back pain, this is for back pain only. And bring hands, off the floor. And off the floor, legs off the floor, yes. Stay there. Yeah.
Superman.
Straight ka vela patta kada.
Swing. You can get the swing. Yeah. If you save a few seconds here, this moves to the back.
So basically pressure.
Dini valle lower back. Idu peruthe lower back.
But
I know I have that.
Okay, that's enough.